Good morning, my dear kids. In today's class, in the chapter Electromagnetic Induction, we are going to discuss some numericals which are application based. So it can be asked in any of the exams where you may appear. So most probably, I'm targeting such questions may come in the advance here. So let me start the class. I think something happened. I think some color changed. I know I could not set it right back. I think you are able to read. We will continue. There's no gravity. There's no gravity. So because of that, it will rotate here. So what was the question that is asked is like expression for that magnetic field. What will the magnitude of flux density of the magnetic field be so that the potential difference between ends of the rod becomes double? Okay, first in the absence of magnetic field, when B is zero. When B is zero, what are the conditions for the rod? It'll be rotating, no? So then what are the forces that will be resulting? So we'll assume a negative charge electron. It will experience a pseudo force. Okay, agree this? Due to centrifugal force, it will get displaced. So then here m omega square r, then negative charge will go and get deposited here. And the absence of electrons here will make a positively charged. And this will set up an electric field vector. What are these red color lines? They are the electric field vector. Now that will make, it will exert electrostatic field. I think already we have discussed, I'm just revising it here. So then at equilibrium, so you can say that how long this thing will occur? The drifting of electrons will take place. Why it will occur? Because centrifugal force will act here. Then as the accumulation of electrons takes place here, so that the deficiency of electrons will become positive charge. No moment of positive charge. They may test you more than one option such questions. Only electrons will get displaced. Then will they continuously displace? No, after some time, there won't be any further drift of electron. Any reason for that? The electrostatic force will be balanced by the centrifugal force. Then at equilibrium, so we'll write it here. F equal to m omega square r, you write it. This one. So what is Fe equal to QE? So this electric field vector, already we have discussed. So once again, I'm just revising. So this will become dV by, or say dE by dr. What should be the limits? I think you have to be very careful in the problem. The overall EMF induced across the rod that is being asked. So this EMF induced, I'll call E. Let it be E only. Now it should be L to L plus L. I think here is what most of you go wrong here. The limit should be from small l to L plus L, not 0 to L. Because at what distance, at what radial distance it is there. So I assumed A. So here is what, what is that dr? What is the dr? Dr is this one. So the r should be from small l to capital L. So this will be r square by 2. This will be L square. Keep this much in hand. L square plus 2LL, this one. Okay, now what you're telling? There is a magnetic field. In the presence of magnetic field, now what conditions will come? Just very simple conditions are introduced here, nothing big. Okay, now there is a magnetic field out of the plane. We can put it everywhere. Okay, this is a B bar, which is out of the plane. How it is being rotated? I just show it here, magnetic field, so that the potential difference, what should be the magnitude of magnetic field? Vertically upward direction is switched on. So we are seeing from the top. Okay, if you assume a small element, it additions. There's a dr same, so this will have velocity v. What is this? It additions r, and this is from the axis. I think we should have all this background. So what is the EMF induced across the small element? I think we can write directly. Let me bring it here. Bv into dr, v is r omega dr, b omega r dr. This I'll call e dash. What should be the limit here? Limit should be small l to l plus l. Once again, b omega r square by 2. B omega, this is, so this will be again it will be similar to L plus small l. And what was the question asked? Now this E dash is twice of 2E. Then he's asking us to get the magnitude of magnetic field. Substitute this and solve for B. Very good problem. Simple, already what we know is being asked. Two times. I'll write it here. So this will become final answer will be 2m. Omega, why omega square? Only omega. Omega by Q. This will be our answer. Okay, this one.
Sure.
Yeah.
It is m omega by q only, no sir. Why did you take another 2 in the denominator, sir?
From here.
Okay, sure.
Okay, two times, no, this is. There's a condition given, no. So the m omega square by 2q in the numerator, there's a given, no. Here I'm just substituting the value of here.
Okay, sir. In the final step, you forgot that 2, so I got one.
No, these two will cancel, no?
No, sir. In final equation of E, when you wrote the final, like E equal to M omega.
Omega square. Here omega square is there. I think, okay, let me. This is E dash B omega. This is omega square. Okay, fine. See, no, I think I'm right. No. There will be different EMFs. So definitely this will be very small, no? Where m is the mass of electron and q is the charge. Here a e given e. Now let me make it q. Will be different. They have to be different. Okay, complete description of the problem. No need of printout, take out. This also we are going to upload it. Another 2-3 days it will be available. Huh? Okay, I'll go to our next question. Magnetism along with EMF due to magnetism. Why magnetism? Which magnetism? Rishit, which magnetism?
In the second situation, we have taken due to magnetic force, we have taken EMF, no, sir.
Then you are asking why not centrifugal force? The value of this will be, so here the centrifugal force will be so small that we can neglect compared to the Lorentz force.
So we are equating both EMFs, so like that, I mean, E dash is equal to E if we keep it.
This is what the question is like. Practically, you look at this, you're just asking, I agree that one, sir. Why don't you bring some, the effect of this centrifugal force also here? Am I right? But in the expression, that will become a very negligible quantity compared to this. That's why he's asking us to get the relationship like this here. Maybe if they give options, we may think. Otherwise, we do bring that also. Otherwise, we can't simplify the expression. What should be the magnitude of magnetism so that the potential between the ends of the rod becomes double? He's asking just double. If you bring that, it's not possible to simplify. This also, I think, little bit carefully. So there's a disk of radius r is there here. This is a solenoid. I think somehow you have to first read the question, understand it. You may manage very comfortably this one. It's not a spring, it's a solenoid. I think in advance, the comprehensions, no, you may get questions of this kind. What is the state of disk? The disk is rotating. I think you have to understand this question very. There's a rod, some mounted along a long solenoid. It's like a end of the shaft. Okay, what is the shaft here? This we'll call it the shaft. Fine. So now the disk starts rotating. So rotating this, will there be any EMF induced? It's a conducting disk. Will there be any EMF induced? Yes, it will be. I think it's very simple. So what is the EMF induced in the rotate? So the rotating disk. So we'll do one thing for our understanding purpose. We will bring points P1, P and O. This and let this be A. Let this be B. A and O will be conducting rod. Okay, then let's see that. So shall we assume now because of this EMF induced B bar. So there's some external magnetic field is there, no? So this conducting disk is rotating in an external magnetic field. There'll be EMF induced. So then B bar velocity. So this sign will be positive, P will be positive, O will be negative. So this everything I can replace with a just simple rod or a battery, a cell. Then it is connected to point P. And this is connected to O, comma A, let it be here. This point P is now connected to emitter. Then will come a resistor. Okay, fine till here, no problem. Then our trouble starts now. After this, where do we are here? No, this is like a solenoid, no? And it is connected to A. So here is what I'll bring the solenoid. And this is the EMF induced. So how that current will flow. I think if you can generate this circuit, problem is over, very simple. Now what is EMF induced? Come for this one, B omega R square by 2. Sir, how come disk you are replacing with a rod? I think if you just draw some thin rod here, what is the potential difference across that rod? Will be same, what is the potential? Because can we assume this disk to be made up of such rods? Can we assume this made up of this rod? We'll find out first EMF induced in this rod. Then can we assume this disk made up of such rods? Then what is the EMF of across all the rods? They'll become parallel and they'll be equal. Please try to understand this. I think for this, we have seen this one. No, let's come for this one. So this expression for I, so it is like a EMF, we know B omega R square by 2. What is it? B now? I think B net, I'll write it. Net magnetic field. EMF is equal to. Now you can ask primary question. So why you made again net? Because as it starts rotating due to external magnetic field, EMF will be induced. Due to EMF induced, now this will be like a cell and it will start pushing the current through the resistor. Here it will encounter a solenoid. And if a current flows through a solenoid, will there be any magnetic field will be produced by the solenoid? Yes, it will be. So there'll be a magnetic field. So due to flow of current here, there'll be a magnetic field. What direction the magnetic field? I think we have to BI, I'll write it. Or BS, you write it, magnetic field produced by the solenoid. So what is BS is equal to? Mu naught Ni. So what is the net magnetic field? It should be equal to B minus BS. So this should be equal to now B BS omega R square by 2. Find the expression for reading of emitter in a steady state for the direction of this as well as its opposite. It's asking at steady state. At steady state, what shall we do? The coil I should replace with a short circuit. Then at I infinity, what we can write it as? Just E by R. We'll substitute all the values. BS equal to mu naught Ni. First, we'll generalize it. This is at I equal to infinity only. Then in the end, we'll write I infinity that one. Now this will become 1 plus, no? This will be mu naught Ni. Mu naught N R omega square by 2. B omega square. Let me write one more step. It'll be easy for us. B omega R square by 2R. Let's solve for I. B omega R square by 1 plus mu naught n omega r square. 2 are will come here. Fine. The simple idea. If I change the direction of external magnetic field B, in anything will happen. I think in the denominator you are going to change the 2R minus. You are going to write it. If omega sense, if I changes, so here what is omega? Omega we took it something like this. If omega changes, then it will be, and it will be steady state current. Don't go for again solving. Try to analyze in the diagram. This will be omega like this. This will be really, I think, unless you don't understand the diagram, the situation, not possible to think in this way. That's what I feel. The question that came in advance, the student should have ability to read first rather than writing equation. Understand the situation clearly, then go for it. I'll slide down. This is some very good situation is I brought it. First, read the question. Unless the without reading, it not be possible. The thickness of that D and thickness of that is given. First case, let it be iron. It is next again. We will make it some dielectric of dielectric constant. Assuming material of the bar to be a dielectric of dielectric constant. What actually happens here now? And there's a diagram is there, so let me go for. I think I have to draw a little bit. There's a thing. So there's the velocity v. You take it. Then there is a magnetic field. This B bar. Able to see this? So the B bar is in this direction. We'll keep it all these things. Then the electron which is present here, that will take help of that electron. So B bar velocity. I think the force will be downward. So there's a magnetic force. So then because of this, the electrons gets deposited. I think I'm right, no? Now upward, sorry. The magnetic force will be upward. FB, I'll write it. Lorentz force, better you can call. So the electron starts getting deposited, and this end, this upper surface will acquire negative charge. Then the deficiency of electrons will lead to positive charge on this one. For finally, what will happen? So how long this drifting of electrons will take place? As long as this and there'll be electrostatic field is set up here, no? E, due to the deposition of charges, accumulation of charges at upper and lower surfaces. Then this electron will experience a force, electrostatic force will be downward. FE and FB. I think I'm able to. FE and this is FB. FB will be upward, FE. So how long this drifting? As long as FE less than FB. Once FE becomes equal to FB, no more drifting of charges will occur. What do we get? We get the deposition. So this will be a little bit difficult to analyze. I will just only take that phase where we are interested. So this will acquire a positive charge density, negative charge density. I think this is the phenomena, simplified diagram, and there's a velocity V. B bar, this is E bar. You know, to the same thing, B bar is what? Perpendicular to plane. So here, FB and FE. I think in exam directly, if you can draw the second diagram, that's better, no? Than with the first diagram all. Please do analyze things. Okay, let's do one thing. We'll equate these two and we'll see anything will get help to get into the problem. We don't know what to do in the problem, no? First, what is FB equal to? QVB equal to Q into E. So therefore this VB is equal to E. What is E? Will change like this. So sigma is equal to now 2VB epsilon naught. Sigma by 2 epsilon naught or sigma by epsilon naught I should take. I think sigma by epsilon naught only. I think it's a very, very, very important. Hardly we have anywhere such questions being asked. Please be careful. That's why I just picked up here. So now this is like I'll say iron. That's all, no? Conductor it is. Please do remember the last expression what I brought, very useful for us in exams. They may trouble you. Our next case is telling it's like a dielectric which will have a dielectric constant. So you have to, I think, a lot of some thinking we have to do here. We know concept, everything. We have to be extra alert that this is a dielectric material, epsilon R. What do you mean by dielectric? Find the surface charges on the upper and bottom face of the bar, assuming material of the bar to be dielectric of dielectric constant. The bar will be still be conducting, and because then only there'll be non-conductor. Yeah, Rudran is correct. Yeah, it'll be non-conductor only, but you can't say that all dielectrics are perfect. You see, I think that's what the difference in the problem. Sir, dielectric means should be non-conductor, need not. Even a conducting material will have some dielectric. If he has said of the bar to be a insulating dielectric material, made up of insulating dielectric material, then no question of drifting charges and the potential difference will be zero. Able to make it out. If I just say dielectric, doesn't mean that it's a non-conducting. So let me write it as a non-dielectric. Don't write there's a non-conducting of the bar to be a insulating dielectric. Okay, I think these are very dangerous things, sir. I think it's stressing that particular word. Okay, how students will take this dielectric. I feel, to be frank, I thought zero answer. Very openly, I'm telling. Then when you went and checked the answer, no, how it is zero? I thought zero, but it's non-zero is there. How come non-zero, there should not be any drift of electrons? Then later on, it didn't say that insulating dielectric. Just say dielectric means it will have some conductivity. So there'll be drifting of charges. I think terminology here, nothing to do, only just terminology. Now what to do here now? So again the same conditions. Plus, this will be negative. It's asking to get that induced charges. So if it is a dielectric, so definitely we'll assume that one. If it's a dielectric, what is the conditions that will arise here? So let's assume that dielectric here. So this particular electrons will get drifted, and meanwhile, as it is a dielectric, so therefore we can assume it's there'll be dipoles. Because of the electric field, the dipoles will get aligned. Will get aligned. So you directly go back to the, he's asking now to get that induced charge. Okay, sigma dash, you write it. But what were the, on the plates, sigma will be there, no? Already we have this one. Now he's asking that induced charge. Find the surface charge difference on upper and the bottom faces of the bar, assuming the material of the bar to be dielectric of dielectric constant. Along with this, there'll be also, due to dielectric pole, there'll be some electric field, no? That has to be taken care. So the induced charge has to be brought. So how to introduce that one? So along with this, this electric field, there'll be also induced electric field come. The difference of that has to be taken. The difference of these two should be equal to, but he's asking to get the induced charge here. So shall we go for this sigma dash equal to sigma into one minus, and what is sigma? Why this? VB epsilon naught, no, it is. Oh, I change symbol. If it is not a dielectric, this will be the potential. Because of dielectric, the formula will become, so the induced charge on the dielectric slab is what he's asking here. What is this sigma? This is due to the induced EMF. I think it was like sigma dash equals sigma one minus one by K, where K is a dielectric constant. That's what we are discussing here. I'll move to the next one. This is a very important. You in your home, you can generate electricity. There's a flowing liquid. So this liquid will be flowing here. So the liquid will flow here, and these are the plates. It's telling the basic principle of magnetohydrodynamic generators for generators. Parallel plate capacitor. So there's a plate. I'll write it. Huh? There'll be other plate, and the connections will be done like this. And there's an external magnet field. This is some sort of like a, you can say like a tube, which will provide support for the flow of liquid. So here I could have done like this. Means it's a continuous, there'll be a tube will be there. Yeah, now get into the problem. With a constant velocity v, so like a, can you show v, that there's a v. Flowing liquid. I think somehow if you can, you have to struggle to understand the situation. Once you get that, problem is very easy. You can sail through the problem very, very comfortably. conducting liquid. So what you can do with that? Very sad to say that in India there are no such research on these things. Very late. Small even African countries, they have come forward in using all these things. In India it became very late. Maybe in the 2000 we have started. Long back 1970s, what happened? The African countries also started this one. Okay, the parallel plate capacitor. So I'll begin like this. So this is the plates of capacitors. So this is what that particular. All these are experimental based questions, application based numericals, not like something numerical. All these are some based on some real applications. Now we have, okay, there's a circuit. Okay, resistor R is here, no? Yeah, we can save some place for us. Yeah, no. So this is R, you take it. Look at the magnetic field. Magnetic field shall be put here out of the plane, B bar. Just shall put only one dot. Make it a plane diagram, it'll be easier. And how the velocity, let's assume a positive charge moving like this. Now this positive charge is moving here. In what direction? It will experience a magnetic force. B bar, it will be upward. Then because of this, a deposition of positive charge will start occurs. Then the lower part of this liquid at other plate, the liquid will acquire negative charge. Then in what direction there'll be induced electric field in this direction, EI. Don't say induced, electric field, or else ITT only, due to drifting of electrons. So now finally, what we can write, FB equal to QE. FB is what? QVB is equal to, this is QE. And because of this, there'll be a potential difference setup. Let's assume that what is V naught is PD, PD across capacitor. No, so this will be, we can write it as VB. This will become, I'll write it as E is uniform. So we'll write it V naught. So V naught equal to B V D. Keep it here. Now, will there be any flow of current? There'll be flow of current. So what is I is equal to now? I is equal to V naught by R, which is equal to B V D by R. Is it only that much or any other thing is there? You try to read the question carefully. Liquid of electrical conductivity and electrical conductivity of the liquid is, I think some symbol missing. I'll bring sigma. The liquid flows between the plates with a constant velocity. So even the liquid will also offer some resistance. So therefore, there should be the resistance, external resistance R plus that of the liquid. But we don't know the resistance of that liquid. Anybody? Area of each plate is A. Distance between the plates is D. So what is a D? This is a D. This is area A. So therefore, this will become conductivity. So this will become A by sigma D. From where we know the resistance of liquid should be equal to rho. Area rho L, no? I think rho D, this will become. So rho D by A. So this will become D by sigma A because we know rho equal to 1 by sigma. resistivity is reciprocal of conductivity. Substitute that one here. So this what our expression will be. This is a current I, which is equal to BVD sigma A R sigma A plus D. Now, what shall I do after this? It's asking the how much power will it dissipate? I think it's quite simple, no? Power dissipated across the resistor equal to I square R. I'll square this, I'll substitute, I'll got the answer. Okay, last question. From where this power come? Anybody answers? I want students to really answer this. From where this power will come? Yeah, Rudransh, correct. Kinetic energy of the liquid. So therefore, some external agent has to do work, no? To maintain the velocity of the liquid. Yes, yeah. Everyone, Rudransh, Asita, Manideep. Okay, yeah, fine. So here, the work done by external agent to maintain the speed of the liquid constant, that work is what converted into power. So instead of this resistor, shall I put here a storing battery? It will start storing energy. So what we have to do? Just make the water to flow through this pipe is enough. Are you getting? No, there's a way of generating electricity now. It is widely used in Western countries now. Water will flow. Where water will flow? In the rivers, canals, even where the drainage water also will flow, no? So what to do for that? You have to just make it a conducting liquid. So of course, river water, we can't do anything. The water is also having conductivity. So that is enough. Water is a good conductor of electricity. I think everyone knows. So what shall I do? If a water is flowing through a canal, okay, just bring this setup. You have to bring that external magnetic field. Of course, Earth's magnetic field is there, but is of very low value. So some of you can bring external magnetic field, problem solved. So where is water is flowing? In the drainage, canals. Okay, rivers we can't construct, but at least the drainage we can construct, no? The Western countries started exploring the energy from that also. The drainage water will flow naturally. They're using it. All these are, you can say, like a electromagnetic induction. Oh, the chapter is such a beautiful, like wide applications. Of course, we are not that strong in terms of research in India, but in Western countries, there's a long back 1970s, this was started implementing in the drainages. Water flows in a drainage, from like a flowing drainage water. From that, they are generating electricity. Just imagine. We are unable to construct drainages properly. Forget about generating electricity. The use of technology. Okay, I think just squaring it, nothing to do. Just square it, this one. So what is the reason I should give? The work done by external agent in maintaining speed of liquid constant is converted as rate of work done will write it. The rate of work done by external agent in maintaining speed of liquid constant is converted as power, electric power dissipated in across resistor R. Very, very useful application. This is one of the, you can say, like a more creative, the best applications. So you do one thing. Are we using this in India? Yes. From, I think, 2008, we started using this one. We imported technology from the abroad and we started using. You go for lift irrigation. The lift irrigation, this is what we are using. So what we do in the lift irrigation, I'll lift the water to certain height. I'll make it to flow. When the water starts flowing, here I'll take a rechargeable cells. Here the electric energy, this energy again will be utilized to lift the water. And this water open, which is, I'll just lift the water. I'll make it to flow here. There's a water, there's a lake. So here I'll construct a something. So now there'll be a, I'll make the water to flow down from a pump. I lift it. Then when this flowing water down, what it does, in turn, it will generate electricity. This electricity, what will happen, will be utilized for what? Again, to lift the water. And this water, what happened? I'm going to pump it. So usually it happens like this. What happened? We can go for the lift irrigations. Okay, do visit. We have plenty of lift irrigations in Telangana where we are using this one. The lift irrigations are very, very, very important part of the modern agriculture. So if you are interested, you can do a lot of good research, everything. When you become high TN, you can really improve the efficiency and crores of farmers will get benefited. Hope so. Okay, we'll do one thing. Take the next question. A thin conducting disc of mass M, thickness D and radius is released in a uniform horizontal magnetic field of induction. Find expression for acceleration of the disc. There is a gravity. Very, very, very nice problem. Let's see that. I'll give at least, I think I'll wait for 2 minutes. Sir. We'll pause it. Now again, there's a plane diagram I give. So at least look at the, because the moment I release, because of the weight, it starts moving down, no? And the action of weight. So I'm more interested in that, the green color, that's why I shaded separate here. So just show that the same diagram, we'll put it in another way. All these problems, I think, need some time, not like something seeing you can solve. I'll bring better diagram. Now, to make you understand, I'm just showing it thick. Let's get into. So this is our region. Okay, start looking at that green color region. Okay, now you analyze things here. Let's see that. How is the B bar? B bar for this second diagram, B bar will be out of the plane. We have stopped thinking like this creatively. What type of method we have developed? Question, answer, then key, then rank. So creative is lost due to this competitive exams. Almost everyone, even me also. Because I had to teach so fast, I had to cover so many numericals. We have stopped all these things. They're the major problem with our competitive exam preparation. And now let's see that, what is the weight, the G will act, the weight of this. So directly you put one red color arrow. It will start accelerating, no? Because of that. So this will acquire velocity V. Okay, now B bar and velocity. So this end, if you take a positive charge, which is there inside, here will experience a magnetic force like this. Then positive charge will be induced on this face. The disc is having two faces. Then the deficiency of electrons here will get a negative charges. Then we'll get a electric field. And now you can ask question, sir, why you're not taking the weight of the electron will be negligible, no, here. How long this drifting will take place? As long as FB greater than FE. The moment FB equal to FE, no more drifting will occur and there'll be a potential difference. Okay, let it be there. I think none, but what was our question? acceleration due to gravity. So finally, what happens here? How to manage this question? Now the drifting of electrons will take place here. Then after this, what I do is like a, what is the, how do it will behave? Shall we say this is like a simple rod? What is the EMF induced across the phases? Should be equal to BVD. This is just equivalent to one rod. That's all. Treat just this like a rod. Then what is the EMF induced across it? That should be equal to, it should be equal to BVD. Then this will, the phases of the disk will behave like a capacitor. Q equal to CE. What is the capacitance of this? Epsilon naught pi r squared d into BVD. This I'll differentiate. Dq by dt, epsilon naught pi r square dv by dt. So what is a dv by dt? Acceleration is equal to dv by dt. So this this should dq by dt nothing but should be equal to I, no? So therefore this I is equal to epsilon naught pi r square b d. This is, yeah, only this much here. Both the D's will cancel out. Okay, this will be acceleration. Is it okay or problem? Okay, now this is like a conducting rod. No, it will do experience. How the current will flow in it? I'll give better diagram. Weight mg, velocity, acceleration, current I. Then the force will be bi d. Here the magnetic field is okay. I think these dots are enough. You have to treat it in this way here. So what is the net mg minus bid equal to me? B into epsilon naught pi r square ba d equal to me. Solving for this, A equal to G by mg will be there. So M plus epsilon naught pi r square B square D. A few questions like, current will it flow, sir? Just asking the acceleration, that one. So finally, like this, there'll be drifting of electrons. Due to that drifting of electron, there'll be current, and due to that current, again, it's expensive B ampere force. we are discussing this one. Then with this, you look at the acceleration. Acceleration will, because of acceleration will be constant, no? There'll be acceleration. Because of acceleration, it'll have V equal to AT. And look at the current. Current will be also a constant. In fact, practically it happens. So what we are studying is something at a very low level. So maybe if you go for Olympiads, no, they may dump with all this stuff of this kind. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
There's no again electrical power. I will take the few more questions I have. Once again, read it. Very nice. I think this is something, okay, circuit. We know LR circuit, how we can manage. You need not to bother about anything. So carefully draw the circuit diagrams. Very good, tricky question. That three new year, shall I continue? Can you hear me? Shall I continue? Kids, any one of you respond? Shall we continue?
Sir, screen is not visible, sir.
Screen is not visible. Huh? Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll share again. Screen not visible. How it is possible? No. Now, Manideep, okay?
No, sir.
Screen not visible. Huh? What to do for this? Stop sharing. I'll get back the screen. Okay, I'll start the. So first at steady state, I think it's quite easy, no? At steady state, I think both the find the current through the and internal resistance are the battery is having internal resistance. I think you have to be very 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 careful here. Intentionally in the diagram not shown, but in the question somewhere it is being stressed. So the internal resistance is R. This I'll write it. Okay, this is. Now first set, find the current through the switch as a function of time after the switching. So first, I think when the switch is at position one, there'll be steady state current will be there. So this current will call it as I naught. And how do that I naught will flow? That the whole I naught will flow through the coils only. Why no current through the resistor R? Because that will be like a short circuit. It will be like a short circuit. The path of the current has to take like this. But at steady state, the inductors will be like a short circuit. Or if you want further help, it is like this. I think this will be quite easy for you now. Okay, the overall the current will take the low resistance path, so that I naught will take path like this. Now, what is I naught? Let's write it. I naught is in fact E by R. Very important. Now the switch is brought to the other portion. So the role of cell will be that there won't be role of the cell. The cell will be totally cut off. Okay, I'm not interested to show that also. Okay, this is the switch. 1 and 3. If you do aribari here, I think gone. It's all about the redrawing the circuit is what will make this problem very, very simple, otherwise very, very complicated. Real experience is you can take your teacher itself. Okay, this is what happens the moment at this is at t equals 0. The moment switch is moved to 1, 2, 3. What will happen to the current? So at t equals 0, what the inductors should be replaced? Open circuit. Should be open and there's a short circuit there, it's shorted. So therefore, at t equals 0, the equivalent diagram is asked to be taken only this much. So why there is no L1? Of course, in L1, there is a energy is present. There'll be energy present, but then since it's a shorted, no, you just write it in this way. So what is the current? Current will be, you call this as the same steady state current which was flowing will be I naught. So this will line the current I2. Okay, let it be here. Now why I2 should be in that direction? In what direction the steady state current was flowing? From A to B, let's introduce some symbols. It'll be easy for us. So now the decay current should flow in the direction of steady state current. Very simple idea. The steady state current was in this direction. The decay current should flow in the direction of steady state current, initial direction of steady state. This will be I2. And we know this is I2. It should be equal to how much? Directly, let me write it here. This should be equal to I0 into e to the power of minus tr by L2. What is I naught? I naught is EMF of the battery. This is a decay current. But he's asking not at t equals zero, find the current to the switch as a function of time after the switching. This is at t equals zero we are discussing. Okay, let's come for this one. Like at any time, I am. This was the point A, B, and this is C, no? So AC is what I should show that one. So CA. Now this redrawing is something very important. So here's an inductor coil, L1, connected across it. Then we have a wire. Then we have a resistor R connected from A to a coil inductor. This L2. So this is what that C and E. This is B, I'll write it. Now here also, this will also start discharging, no? So there'll be current. And now again, what was the current here, no? How the steady state current, it was flowing from C to A. So therefore the decay current here should flow in this direction. And this current has to flow like this. So this was the current you call I1. Where the current, the resultant current through the coil, this will say I. So I1, I2 minus I1 should be equal to I. No, sir, what is I1? What is this I1? Anybody wants to answer I1? Yeah, anybody wants to answer I1? See, there's no resistor, so therefore this current will be constant. So what is I1? I1 should be equal to this I0. This is a trick of the problem, because there is no any dissipative element in this loop. So the steady state current which is there, that only will flow here. So therefore this I1 should be equal to I0 here. So actually the steady state current, it will flow like this, no, A to C. So therefore we have took in this way. So this I1 should be equal to I0. So the I2 should be at any time like this. The difference of these two is what should be equal to I. There is a current through the inductor. So therefore here, now I'll write one very important, this I think, any reason for that? Because there is no dissipative element in this loop. So what are this current? It will stay there like that only. The difference of these two, this I2 will be decreasing, continues to decrease. Sir, after some time, so what we are asking, I'm asking you to calculate this current, no? Find the current through the switch as a function of time t after the switching. So where is the switch now? So this is what the switch. So the switch will come here. So this was the current. Find totally dissipating resistor R after the switching. I think what current that flows here, that has to be taken here to find out the totally dissipated. I think the first answer for option A, what shall I write? Should be equal to I1 and there should be equal to I0. This is for A, I'll write it, part A of the problem. Let's come for part B of the problem. What is the part B of the problem? The difference of these two. With the time, what will happen to this current? This will become zero. This will become zero. And how these two are? These two will come in series with this, with this short-circuited wire. So after a long time, will there be any flow of current here? Shall we write only this is our answer, or will you take the difference of these three? What this sign? This is at that instant only. At any time t, we have to bring it. So now I'll get into the next part of the problem. This I should be equal to I1 minus I2. Then what is I2? I1 is I0, I2 is E by R, TR, L2. So what is I0? I0 again, we have already derived it. Find the totally dissipated in the resistor R is telling. For that, what we should do here? This heat only will go there, that's all. I think the part B further. I just wanted to give this information of I. Further, HR should be equal to L2 I0 square by 2R only. What is I? I is a current through the coil at any time t. This is at t equals zero, we brought it at that instant. The difference of these two is what will be the total current. once at t equal to infinity, there won't be I2. So no question of this I here, then the only current will be like this. I think this will be a little bit confusion. This is at time t. At time t only, not applicable at t equal to infinity. This will be very strange conditions is what I'm writing. Not applicable again at t equal to infinity. Because at t equal to infinity, it will be only like this. These are some circuits are there. If you just take some engineering books, no, you do have plenty of like this 5-6 inductors thrown like this. Usually we do with only one inductor. With more than one inductor, I think we have to be very, very extra alert. Things are not that easy. Okay, we'll end up the class. Okay, thank all of you.